Hello, I'm Jordan, and today I'm going to show you how to replace the cartridge in your Zephyr air pollution monitor. So this can be carried out both in the field or indoors, whatever is best for you. But what you will need is access to the top and the bottom of your Zephyr. You'll need your new cartridge that's been sent to you and a 3mm Allen key. So to get started, we need to make sure that the battery is not depleted on your Zephyr. So to do that, we just click the top button and the resulting blue light indicates that there is power. If you don't get that light, you'll need to power your Zephyr before you do this. So the way that the cartridge swap mode works is that it's different to normal sampling operations. So we need to use the button at the top to prepare the Zephyr so it can take the new cartridge safely. So to do that, we need to push, hold on the button until it goes green. Let me take our finger off, and then we will see that the light is flashing green and blue, and that indicates that we're in cartridge swap mode. So now we can remove the old cartridge. Now this is slightly easier to do in the office. If you are in the field up a ladder, I would suggest holding the bottom of the cartridge to make sure that you can remove it safely. But if you are working horizontally like this, it just nicely pulls out. So we remove our old cartridge, push that over to the side, and then we take our new one, put that in. It's a slightly snug fit when it gets close, but that is good. And then we tighten those screws nice and tight, but not too tight because it is into plastic. Okay, so now we have our new cartridge in. We're still in swap mode. So what we can now see is that the light is still flashing green and blue as it was when we started the procedure. Now to end it, we will do the same button push as we did before, push, hold. But what we then need to pay attention to is the light sequence that follows. So before we end it, I'll run you through what that sequence means. So firstly, we will get one blue flash, and that will tell us if there is anything in this slot here. If there is a cartridge, it will flash green. If there is not a cartridge, it will flash red. So we would expect to see a red. And on this side, it will flash blue to then tell us what's in this side. And as before, green if there is a cartridge and red if there is not. So this one should flash green. So the total sequence should be blue, red, blue, green. So now let's check that that is the case. So push, hold to take it out of swap mode, and then finger off when it goes green. Then we've got blue, red, blue, green. So now we have completed the cartridge swap mode, and you are now ready to start taking measurements again with your Zephyr with its new cartridge. Thank you.